welcome. This is an overview of this week's top stories expected to keep making headlines in the days to come. Turkey's 9/11. On Saturday, a double bombing attack in Ankara during a pro-Kurdish peace protest killed more than 100 people and marked the beginning of a new period of instability and insecurity for Turkey. Two men are considered suspects for the deadly attack, who are said to have spent time in Syria next to ISIS fighters. The Turkish government has imposed a temporary media blackout on the deadly attack until those behind it are caught. 10 people have been put in custody, while 12 more have been detained for out-of-line comments on Twitter regarding the incident. US and Russia hold talks anew over the Syrian crisis. Russia and the United States are set to hold a new round of talks on air safety in Syria after details emerged that combat aircrafts from both countries came within a mile of each other on Saturday. It will be the third round of talks as the two countries seek to find ways of avoiding an accidental conflict. EU concedes to Turkish terms in order to get aid for the migrant crisis. Hollande said that EU leaders agreed on the European Commission programme for Turkey, adding that processes to lift visa regulations for Turkish people will be speed up. The country will also have its pre-accession arrangements quickened, leaders at the summit agreed. Financial compensation, he said, has been agreed, but not to the exact amount, as it depends on the measures that Turkey will take to stem the flows of refugees. Greece did express its concern on the issue, with Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras saying the agreement with Turkey must not entail any compromises on critical issues, especially on matters of national sovereignty, a point agreed upon by all EU members. Cyprus and China look to strengthen their ties. The Cyprus problem, the economy, energy and the prospects opening up for significant Chinese investments to Cyprus were among the issues discussed during Thursday's meeting of the President of the Republic with his Chinese counterpart in Beijing. Asked whether the issue of energy was raised at the meeting, President Anastasiadis said that there was an extensive dialogue with regard to energy issues, especially taking into consideration the technical expertise of this friendly country, and there was interest expressed so that in any future licensing to have greater participation on the part of the Chinese state. In addition to that, President Anastasiadis announced that Cyprus has already applied for regional membership to the fledgling Asian Infrastructure and Investment Bank. Cyprus, recognizing the importance and the scope of this initiative, has already applied to become a regional member of the bank, Anastasiadis stated. Leaders agree to disagree on bizonality, as usual. The leaders of the two communities in Cyprus agreed to disagree after their almost four-hour meeting on Monday, which was followed by a late dinner at a restaurant inside the buffer zone. However, strain was caused in light of new statements from Mustafa Akinci that between the two sides there is a difference in the perception of bizonality. The Turkish Cypriot leader reportedly insisted on certain positions, especially as regards to bizonality, on legitimate derogations from the acquis, as well as considering the issues of population and territorial majority. President Anastasiadis rejected these positions. The two negotiators, Andreas Mavroyiannis and Ostil Nami, will now try to find common ground ahead of the second meeting between the two leaders, which takes place on October 30th. Not all is bad news, though. On Wednesday, it was announced that the Verinia crossing will open by the end of the year. The Lefka crossing seems to be next. On another level of developments, world-famous actor Daniel Craig was on the island early this week as UN global advocate for the elimination of mines and explosive hazards to see how demining missions of the UNFIGIP are going in the buffer zone. I very much hope that I will be the first and last global advocate to see landmines on this beautiful island, he said. Thank you for watching.